everyone. This is the WNBA on Hoopa Sports. And tonight, we'll see the Chicago Sky as they go up against the Las Vegas Aces. Courtside with Tim Schwartz and Brian Benefitenni, I'm Blake Suniga, and we've got a fun one. And it's going to be the Sky off the tip. Pass to Quigley. Parker. Vandersloot with it. Six to shoot. That's in, coming off an assist from Candace Parker.
I love how Vandersloot is not afraid to fight for it. Just finds a way to finish through contact.
Bambi outside. Gray outside. Pass to Cambage. Good on the shot.
Pays great attention to detail. Gray is alert and constantly looking for open teammates.
Vandersloot with it, working on Wilson. Fast break, here we go. Here's Hamby. Goes up and lays it in nice and easy.
Tremendous work by Hamby, winning the rebound. And she puts it right back up for the bucket.
Pass to Dolson. Drops in the tray.
I tell you, she loves getting looks like that from three-point range. Just nobody near her.
Gray outside. Wilson. Parker defending. Here's Gray. And the officials whistle a foul on the shot. The bucket's good, and she'll go to the line.
The 11th pick in the 2014 WNBA draft, Gray's career has really started to take shape in recent seasons.
Now here's Vandersloot. Tries again, and the layup is good.
Where was the box out? Some easy second chance points.
Those kinds of mistakes on the glass will kill a team.
Hamby with the ball, covered by DeShields. Gray outside. To Hamby, and so it looks like the Aces will retain possession here.
A nice play to get a hand to that pass and tip it out of bounds.
She was just a hair away from coming up with the steal there. Good effort.
Here in the first, with just under 2.5 minutes played so far, and as the shot clock expires, 24-second violation. Here's Vandersloot. Outside to Shields. Three-pointer. It's hauled in by the Aces.
That's a shot you want to take if you're looking for the three. Defense totally off balance.
And Williams gets it to go.
Silky smooth floater from Raquana Williams. She made the right strategy selection there to beat the defense.
Now here's DeShields. Pass to Vandersloot. Here's Dolson. Defended by Cambage. And it's Dolson missing. The Aces leading. Inside. Unloads. Nice D from Allie Quigley. To the middle. Vandersloot outside. Pass to Dolson. She uses the glass on the layup.
A solid 6'5 player. Dolson has the mentality, more importantly, to be a great big in this league, not fazed by contact.
Now here's Williams. Back to Gray. Cambage. Yes! Great play by Chelsea Gray to set it up.
Defense was pretty much non-existent there. Can't leave such a good shooter open like that. Come on.
Pass to Vandersloot. Back to the Shields.
Clock at four. Shoots over Wilson and misses it off the right side of the rim.
Outside Williams. Out of bounds, it'll go to the Sky. Chicago with the ball. They trail by three. DeShields with it. Gray picks her up. Chicago again missing. And the Aces with possession. Outside Plum. To the paint. Hamby. And she'll shoot free throws. Clearly fouled on the shot that time. The whistle blows. And that's going to be a foul on Chicago. And it's her first trip to the line. And she knocks down the first one.
It seems like every year, De'Erica Hamby just gets better. And that's a testament to her drive and work ethic.
Both shots good from the stripe. Chicago trailing here. Outside Boyd. Here's Stevens. And the Sky get it back. That one falls.
Strong rebounding, and she gets the easy putback as a result.
Outside Plum. Young. Back to Plum. Pass to Paris. Six on the shot clock. Outside Plum. Back to Wilson. And there's the whistle on the shot. Took the foul. Shot misses. And she'll shoot two. And that's going to be a foul on Chicago. This is her first trip to the free throw line tonight. And she makes the first.
A unanimous winner of the WNBA's Rookie of the Year Award, Wilson entered the league with a bang.
So she gets them both. Now Quigley. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game for her. Passed a little. Down low. Count the bucket. Coming off a perfectly placed assist.
The pick, the roll, and the dish. Boyd is just a playmaker, and she'll make a difference out there in whatever situation you throw her in.
Now here is Carson. Stevens grabs the board. Outside Quigley. That one goes. Count it.
Wow. You don't see her make plays like that very often, but that was a nice move there for the basket.
Wilson outside. Young. Boyd covering. Outside Plum. Clock at six. The three-pointer, no good. Pass to Endor. They now take the lead.
It makes it so easy for your teammate when you can lead her to the rim with a pass like that.
Now here's Young. Carson covered by Little. Here's Wilson. Hits the jump hook.
Another lead change. How many of these are we going to see?
I don't know, but I'm willing to bet it's more than a few.
Passed a Little. Here's Endor. Boyd. Endor. And count it. 2 points with a chance for one more at the line.
They continue to get it inside. The defense struggling to just contain them.
And look, when you make five in a row from in tight like they have, it also just takes pressure off of your perimeter guys.
Great point.
And the free throw, no good. The ace is trailing. Pass to Paris. Basket counts. And here is Boyd. No scoring yet from her, but that's likely to change. Now a timeout called by Chicago.
Yeah, coach wants to get everybody on the same page out there and maybe change up some things as well.
Yeah, that's probably a good timeout. You might as well talk things through.
And kind of change that game plan as well.
And it's going to be two free throws. Drew contact on the shot.
Drafted ninth overall in the 2015 WNBA draft, Boyd went on to lead all rookies in steals per game.
And first trip to the free throw line for her in this one. Free throw is good. And good on both. And it's the Aces with the ball. They trail by one. Pass to Young. Side Carson, now Plum. Here's Paris, down to five on the shot clock, and she makes that one.
If someone is open, Plum will find them. She's got phenomenal court vision.
Pass to Boyd.
Well, you have to like their work in the boards here in the first.
Yeah, coming out of the gates with great energy. Kind of like they got shot out of a cannon. They're really setting the tone.
Boom. Neither team can miss early on. I don't know how long they can keep this up.
Offensively, at least. Neither team's done jack on D yet.
That's fine with me.
And out of bounds, the Aces will take it. And they have certainly been looking locked in offensively.
They sure have, staying aggressive and playing in control.
Pass to Paris. Good.
There's a pattern taking shape. They're working it inside and getting good shots from close range.
Yeah, four of their last five baskets have been of exactly that variety.
And 5 second differential between the shot clock and game clock. Shot clock at six. Passed to Little. Boyd, she's guarded by Wright. Little's shot is off.
The shot was there for her. She had to take it. And I don't care if she didn't convert. She should take it again next time.
We've seen some great shots in the first quarter. No shortage of offense. The Aces on top. They're up by five. And the second quarter is on the way when we return.
Ladies and gentlemen, dance team.
And guys, what What's your take on the Aces so far?
Really hard work being put in from the glass by them from the get-go.
Yeah, everyone's done a great job boxing out for them here, and it's showing up on the stat sheet.
The Aces leading. Here's Young, right outside. Pass to Carson, and here's Young. Just four to shoot. Here's Paris, and she drops in the layup off glass.
And they continue to control the glass.
I think they've been the more physical team, guys, and that's why they're ahead.
Usually the more physical, more aggressive team wins the game.
Here's Copper. And there's the whistle. Fouled hard on the shot, and we'll go to the line. Jackie Young picks one up. And she's got her first free throws of the night right here. The first one falls, and the Sky making a change here. And good on the second, so she makes both. And here are the Aces now. It's a 5-point game. Pass to Williams. Here's Paris. Here's Gray. Her second shot goes in. Off to a good start. 2 for 2.
Another bucket in the paint. That's just something they have not been able to stop today. And if they want to win this game, they got to figure out how to stop it.
You know, Brian, I think it's time to switch things up on D. What they've got going on right now is not getting it done.
Let's it go for 14, and again, it's Las Vegas.
The mechanics of Gray's jumper when you break them down are unshakable. The team's confidence in her abilities is well placed.
Now here's Dolson. She has 7. Shot clock at 5. Copper. The shot comes out, and Las Vegas the other way now.
They are really getting the work done inside with their rebounding, Tim.
They haven't allowed many second chances. It's been one and done for the most part, and that's helped them build this lead.
3-on-3. Stolen by Cambay. Right outside. Gray outside. Over Parker. Here's Paris. And there's 2 points. Work on the glass, paying off that time.
That rebound and the follow, it shows you what she's all about. Gritty, determined, and a soft touch to the mat.
A nice shot by Vandersloot.
The jumper is so much better from Vandersloot. Remember back in her rookie year in 2011? She was under 40% from the field. Now she's normally around 50%. Well, you gotta like her shot selection today. She set the bar for the rest of the team.
Vandersloot outside. To the inside. Parker, good.
Well, that's why fans love to watch Parker play. She's creative and routinely makes tough shots.
Pass to Cambage. Come on. Outside Williams. Here's Paris. Parker defending. Releases. The putback. Rebounded by Parker. The Sky trail. Courtney Vandersloot for 3. Sinks the triple.
Well, how nice of a teammate. After all the time, Vandersloot sets her up, provides the pass for Courtney to knock down a shot of her own.
Timeout called, the Aces. We'll be right back. Aces with the ball. Their biggest lead of the game was 9. Williams can't get it to go.
What appeared to be an easy 2 points just went straight out the window.
Out to Vandersloot. Pass to Copper. Just 5 on the clock. From past the arc, it's a deflection. The Aces leading. Wilson outside. Doesn't go that time. Nice D from Diamond to Shields. Parker with the ball. Hamby covering. The Shields can't hit. And here are the Aces now. Derek Hamby on the wing. Ball's knocked loose. And that's out of bounds. Las Vegas for the King's possession. Boyd with the steal. Fast break Chicago. And here's Allie Quigley outside. That's good, and it's Candace Parker with the assist.
The ball movement on this run has been fantastic, and it's a big part of why they've been able to get good looks.
Absolutely, the defense unable to react quickly enough to deal with their passing.
Now here's Williams to end the drought. Does not score again, and that's her 4th miss against one mate. Outside Quigley. Pass to Boyd. Launches a 3. Offensive rebound. Dolson's shot's good.
Another reason you want Dolson on your team. She can turn a missed basket into points. Tremendous effort on the boards.
Now a timeout called by Las Vegas.
Yeah, I think the coach is trying to take the wind out of their sails here. They're on the wrong end of a run and need to sort things out offensively and defensively.
Yeah, things were starting to spiral out of control on them a little bit, and a timeout was a no-brainer there.
Exactly, Brian.
Aces with the ball. They trail by 1. Here's Cambage. Another miss, and they desperately need a bucket. And Wilson gets it to go.
Gotta appreciate the hustle. Wilson doing whatever she can to keep possessions alive.
Pass to Quigley. The 3. Down it goes for her 3rd basket in as many tries.
They're getting a lot of their points outside the paint. 3 of their last 5 buckets are from 3-point range.
The defense, they have to close out quicker.
Now here's Plum. Looking for her 1st basket still in this one. Tipped away. And they're running. Buries the jumper to finish the break.
One of the best skills Plum has. Her release. It's so fast, especially off the feet.
A little outside. Pass to Quigley. Unable to get that one to go. Excellent D there from Kelsey Plum. And here they go. And Wilson gets it to go.
Love the selfless, intelligent play by Hamby. Puts the ball into the wide open shooter's hands.
Outside Stevens, Quigley, 6 on the shot clock. Left side Stevens, and looks like an illegal pick was set. That'll get the ref's attention.
The idea of setting a screen on that play, it was the good idea, the right idea, but the execution was not.
Yeah, you really want to set a hard screen, but you also want to make sure it's a legal one.
Now here's Cambage. He has 5. Pass to Gray. Five to shoot. Shoots over Quigley. And it's off the back of the rim. No good. Down low. It's good. And the assist that time from Diamond to Shields.
Whoa, the long bomb. Allie Quigley has no fear to let it fly. It's in her DNA to shoot.
Gray outside. Wilson guarded by Quigley. And Wilson gets it to go.
They've shown some great passing on their last few trips down the floor. You got to imagine that. Their coach is very happy with that.
Four straight passes leading to scores. That's just great team play.
Well, if this ball game comes down to the rebounding battle, they'll be the ones coming out on top.
They've had a strong game on that front, without question.
Oh, they're really pushing it now. It's like they're showing off.
And three of their last five makes coming in transition.
Now here's the Shields. Quiet so far offensively, searching for first points of the game. Here's Quigley. Miss Gambage with the rebound.
We don't see that too often. Plenty of space, and she whips on an open jumper.
Count it.
Hey, look, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. They keep getting in the paint, and they keep scoring points.
And you know, Brian, there's not really a lot you can do as a defense when they keep getting in the paint like they have been on this run.
And the shot goes down.
Using A-plus awareness to find the wide-open teammate, DeShields doesn't mind distributing.
Pass to Carson. Gray outside. Plum. And so it's a close game as we wrap up the first half of play. Aces ahead. They're up by four. And don't go away after the break. We'll see you right back here for the start of quarter number three. You know, Asia Wilson has been really making it happen.
It's amazing to watch. She spoils us with her performances game in, game out. And so far, another big scoring night for her.
And oftentimes, when she puts up that many points in the first half, she follows it up with an even better second half. So we'll see if that happens again here.
Well, both sides have assessed what they need to do over the break, and we'll see if one can pull away in the third. Outside, Williams. Pass to Cambage. To the left side wing. Gray with it. Can't hit it from 12 feet. Parker with the ball, and it's Wilson picking her up. Williams with it. She was fouled on the way up. Two free throws for her. That one on to Shields.
Gotta credit the effort there from Williams. Her aggressiveness is what forces the D to act.
And this is her first free throw of the game. Number two. First one falls for her.
Throughout her career, Raquana Williams has struggled with injuries, but she seems to always come back even stronger.
And so she hits both. Chicago trailing here. Vandersloot left side.
Never afraid to take it inside. Even at 5'8", Vandersloot finds ways to get free throws.
This is her first opportunity at the line this evening. And the first one drops.
A multiple-time All-Star, Vandersloot is such a difference maker for her squad. You can see the play of her teammates elevate when she's involved.
She hits both from the stripe. And here are the Aces now. Now Gray can't get it to drop. She's made four and just missed her four. This Cambage with the block.
I mean, let me be honest with you. That's not who you want to challenge. This Cambage, 6'8", mobile, intelligent. She has it all defensively.
Now here's Vandersloot. 11 points in the game. Pass to Parker. Here's Dolson. That's another one for her. Her fifth in just seven shots.
Scoring inside, it's about a lot of things. To me, touch is most important. And Dolson knows how to get the ball in the hoop.
Wilson, Parker defending. And Wilson gets it to go.
They're doing a terrific job of getting the ball inside, attacking the paint. That's an area, and it's a key area on the court that they control.
Yeah, once they identified what an edge they had inside, they just continued to attack.
Now here's Dolson. Just three to shoot. Shoots over Cambage. And it's Dolson missing.
They start the second half, 1-for-4.
Here's Williams. That one doesn't drop. Allie Quigley with some nice D. Pass to Vandersloot. Now Parker. Outside to Shields. Vandersloot outside. And Erica Hamby is going to pick up the foul. That's her first foul. So it's both teams making substitutions here. A little over 2.5 minutes off the clock in this final half of play. Outside to Shields. 5 on the clock. Second shot opportunity. Foul call that time on the way up. And that'll give her 2 chances at the free throw. It goes on Asia Wilson. It's her first trip to the line. And the first one at the line is good.
Third pick in the 2018 WNBA draft. DeShields went on to have a terrific rookie campaign.
And that's good as she hits both shots. 3 minutes gone now in the third quarter. Now here's Young. Right outside. Back to Young. Just 5 to shoot. Right outside. Pass break Chicago. Here's Copper. And stolen by Asia Wilson. Pass break Las Vegas. Pass to Paris. That's good. And so Asia Wilson with the assist.
Quality dish by Wilson. Good heads-up basketball helps her find the open player.
Parker's shot's good.
Down there in the low post is where you want to create a lot of your offense.
And here is Wright. She's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. And that's a foul called on to Shields. That's her third foul of the game. Outside, and that's a foul called on to Shields. That will get her fourth foul of the game.
That's her fourth foul, and I'm sure she picked it up a little earlier than she would have liked.
To the wing, right side. 6 to shoot. Here's Paris. Good once again. That makes her 8-for-9 this game.
Ran her defender straight into that screen to open up the lane to the hoop.
Here's Copper. That one good for 2.
She didn't have to slow down at all. That lead pass was timed perfectly.
Perfect half at the free throw line for them. That'll help their comeback effort for sure.
Yeah, those free throws are helping them keep contact.
Pass to Wilson. Outside Carson. To the paint. And that one's good. Wilson.
Well, once Wilson catches fire, she stays hot. Her aggressiveness on offense is why her teammates keep feeding her.
Here's Copper, 7 points in the game. Vandersloot, pass to Dolson. Shoots a fader, misses off the right iron. The Aces with the lead. Outside Plum. Rebound Chicago. Here's Vandersloot, 11 points in the game. Rejected by Jackie Young. And now the Aces on the break. And that one's good. Wilson.
No misses for her yet in this quarter. Solid as a rock.
Now a timeout called by Chicago.
Really, they're not pleased at all with the look they've given up inside. And they want to talk to the team about tightening things up defensively.
Well, that's what's got to happen. And I'm sure the coaches will let them know about it. I mean, they're playing some soft interior defense. And that's a recipe for disaster.
Trail. Pass to Vandersloot. Stevens. Now Boyd. Guarded by Young. To the middle. Wilson with the steal. And now the Aces on the break. Plum with it. Rejected by Brittany Boyd. Inside. Wilson with it. She's guarded by Stevens. Here's Paris. And down it goes. 2 points.
Not much resistance on the inside. That's their fifth consecutive make in the paint.
Those looks they're allowing are almost automatic. In fact, I'll just say it, they are automatic.
Here's Endor. Wilson, left side.
If you don't stay grounded when defending an intelligent scorer like Wilson, she'll make you pay 8 out of 7 days a week.
And this is her third and fourth free throw attempts of the game here.
2 shots.
First free throw is good. The Aces making a switch. And she makes both free throws.
They should keep fighting their way to the line, guys. This half, it's been nothing but success for them there.
Taking full advantage from this charity strike. They've yet to miss here in the second half.
Can they get it? Chicago again missing.
She's gone cold, and I'm not sure she's their best option offensively as they look to cut this deficit.
Jesse Plum drives in. Here's Campbell. Offensive sets, and they really want to turn it around.
They got to lock in and need a basket just to regain some momentum.
Took advantage of some shoddy D there. They got to at least get a finger on her.
sends Carson on the wing. Goes up at the elbow. They get it back. And there it is.
It's not hard to see why they're giving up points on this run. Just too many looks from in close.
You know, usually when teams give up runs like this, it's because they allow chances from inside. Make them beat you from deep.
So both teams making some changes here.
A true international star, born in England, playing for Australia, playing all around the world, Liz Cambage has perfected her craft to become one of the best players in the entire world.
Here's Endor. Boyd with it. On the wing, Allie Quigley. From deep three-point range, and they force the shot clock violation. Great defense. And these guys have had some good motion on offense. Nice assists.
When everybody's involved offensively, it's in a way helping you defensively too.
Wilson.
Yes.
Great play by Chelsea Gray to set it up.
They're in the position they're in right now thanks in no small part to the show she's putting on this quarter.
Here's Endor. Pass to Quigley. Clock at six. Here's Dolson. Asia Wilson grabs the board.
And not only increased their rebound advantage, they've definitely been winning that battle today.
And control the boards has given them control of this game. Again and again, they're pounding the defense and creating high percentage looks from close range.
And even under pressure in tight, they've maintained their concentration and converted their opportunities.
Solid work right there. There's a big difference in field goal percentages of these teams in the second half.
And that difference has come about because we've got one team moving sharply, getting good shots, and the other just a little bit stagnant. It's tough to watch.
Yeah, one coach did his job at halftime. The other, not so much.
And the ball is tied up, so we'll have a jump ball. And so it's Chicago with it. Time. And this could get even more out of hand if they continue to put up points.
What a performance it's been.
Just 1 second between the shot clock and game clock. To the inside. She gets that one.
Chalk up a few more points for them. This has been a one-sided game in just every area.
Absolutely. Their defense, their offense, it's all been outstanding.
It's just been a tremendous performance, Brian.
As we end the third quarter, a double-digit deficit will make it tough to come back. Aces ahead, leading by 17. And we'll have the start of the fourth quarter for you as soon as we get back from this short break. And a worthy candidate tonight as we take a look at our State Farm assist of the game.
Oh, this was some artistry right here. Great decision on where to go with the ball and a perfect delivery.
And they'd love to see every possession end this way, Tim. It's true team basketball.
It's just so much fun to watch.
And we welcome you back as we get going into the fourth quarter. The final quarter of play can change everything. Here's Copper. Pass to DeShields. Now here's Quigley. And two free throws coming up as she misses that one, drawing the whistle on a lot of contact there. It goes on Kelsey Plum. That one misses.
Well, she went from someone who didn't even play 10 minutes a game to a player making all-star games. Allie Quigley, a great example of work and perseverance.
And she's good on the second. Now Plum. Pass to Williams. And here's Cambage. Here's Gray. At basket number six, their stat sheet. She's now 6 for 10.
A dangerous playmaker with an assortment of moves. Gray is a defender's worst nightmare.
Dolson with it, and Williams picks her up defensively.
They get it back. Dolson's shot's good.
Oh, it's a good thing she showed up today, because without her, they'd be in deeper trouble.
We're just over a minute into this final quarter of play. Erica Hamby with the drive. It's not going to go for her.
Great defense right there to prevent one of the best finishers in the league from converting in close.
Pass to Endor. Shot clock at six. Back to Quigley.
Shoots over Plum.
Quigley's shot is off. And now the Aces on the break. The open shot by Kelsey Plum. Another shot. Got a piece of it. To the paint, Copper. Yes, and it's Allie Quigley picking up the assist.
Even for a player like Quigley, who is known for her ability to score, you have someone that open, you can't miss her.
Cambage, guarded by Dolson. Pass to Hamby. Uses the glass to finish the layup.
Good pass work. The assist was right on target.
Timeout called the Sky.
Noticing the squad was getting a bit worn out there, and coach called time to let him grab a drink and revitalize.
Chicago now. It's a 16-point game. Pass to DeShields. Quigley. She's guarded by Williams. It's stolen by Hamby. A one-on-one situation. Beyond the arc. Rebound Chicago.
She's had an off game, but her team has been able to pick up the slack and get it done here today.
That shot off. And Las Vegas the other way now. They led the game at one point by 20. Pass to Cambage. Misses the three. On offense, here the Sky. Here in the fourth, they've only allowed just 4 points.
Well, you love to see that offensive mindset from DeShields, and really she's showing that she is not afraid to extend her range.
Now here is Hamby. Wilson, left side. Six on the shot clock. Hamby. With Juana Williams for three. Allie Quigley with some nice D. Down low. Pass to Parker. Outside to Shields. Now Dolson. Good for basket number seven tonight on a not-so-unlucky 13 shots.
Well, you're not going to pass up that type of look.
Cambage with it. Hamby outside. Pass to Wilson. And count the basket. She was fouled, and she's going to the line for one more. Thank you. Chicago now. They trail by 14. Lays it up and banks it in.
Well, if there's somebody open on the court with the same jersey on, Vandersloot will find her. Incredible court vision.
Timeout called the Aces.
Well, they want to tinker with the game plan a little bit, and now's the time to do it.
Yeah, there was clearly some things going on out there that the coaching staff just wasn't a fan of.
Williams. Pass to Cambage. Now here is Hamby. Williams inside. Guarded by Quigley. Counts the basket.
She's starting to turn it on now after a slow start.
Vandersloot outside. Get that one. Nice D from Chelsea Gray.
Plus eight for the rebound differential. One more reason they have absolutely just controlled this game.
Yeah, double-digit advantage on the scoreboard. They've taken the initiative for sure.
And it started out with the rebounding. It sets a tone.
Now here's Quigley with the floater. Back to Vandersloot. Offline with the three.
Well, she had one three in the first half, but so far in the second, she's come up empty.
Nice pass. She got that ball right into her teammate's shooting pocket, and it yielded great results.
Vandersloot outside. Here's to Shields. Good D by De'Erica Hamby. Wilson outside. Pass to Williams. Hamby. Some solid defense from Diamond to Shields. And so it's Chicago with it. It's an 18-point game. Vandersloot outside. Six to shoot. And the foul on Williams. That's her first foul. Quigley with it. Williams there. And so she draws the foul on the shot. A trick to the line to shoot two. And it goes on Raquana Williams.
Two shots.
The first one falls. That's also good, so she hits them both. And confident play we're seeing out of them.
Yeah, the scoreboard tells the story.
Hamby outside. Gray outside. Down to five on the shot clock. The shot off that time, and Chicago will come the other way. And here is Vandersloot. Here's to Shields. That shot, no good. Nice defense from Asia Wilson. To the middle. Candace Parker with the steal. Wilson with the steal. Here's Williams. Pass to Cambage. Now Gray. Juana Williams.
so skilled at the catch-and-shoot game. Williams doesn't need much time or space to get her shot off.
Now a timeout called by Chicago. And you just have to like what we're seeing from Wilson.
He has absolutely worn them out in the paint. They need to come up with a plan to limit the damage she's doing inside.
And so it's Chicago with it, trailing by 19. Pass to Parker. Basket good.
The experience of Parker, it makes her tough near the hoop. She just figures out ways to score.
Outside Williams. Gray, double team on Chelsea Gray. And stolen by Dolson. Pass to DeShields. Soft touch off the glass.
If you give DeShields a driving lane, she will take it. That's the assertiveness coaches appreciate.
Gray with it. Ambi outside. Clock at six. Here's Wilson. And good work on the boards, and they pick up the second chance points.
And that caps off what's been a phenomenal showing for them.
Yeah, Tim, I'd like a piece of that cake if I could have it.
What type of cake?
Now here's Quigley from outside the arc. At basket number six to her stat sheet, she's now 6 for 10.
Over her 10-plus season in the league, Quigley has become a threat to score off the dribble. The screener helping her there.
Williams with it. Now guarded by Dolson. To the inside. Here's Bambe. Goes back up. And Wilson finishes it off.
She is setting this place on fire. Her shooting has been off the charts.
To the paint, Parker. And that comes off the assist by Courtney Vandersloot.
This run really not doing them any good, coming as late as it has.
Yeah, but give them credit for showing the fight they're showing, Tim. It would have been real easy to just throw in the towel by now.
Yeah, but it's still going to be a loss, probably.
So it's the Aces winning this one easily. And that'll wrap it up.